think that you will see humans go to Mars in your lifetime.
My name is Kobe Boykins. I'm a mechanical engineer at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. My specific job on this rover is to build everything that moves. As an engineer, we have to understand what this surface and what it's like for us so that we can drive around. We're gonna take some of that knowledge, help get you guys acquainted with Mars so that you can start to build and develop a community. If you take the United States, North America, South America, Asia, Europe, all the different continents, and you put those together, that would be about the size of Mars. No water on Mars that we know of, at least not liquid. You won't see trees and bushes and things like that. We don't see any life, quote unquote life, but we will see volcanoes and mountains. Unlike Earth, Mars has a very thin atmosphere. Mars is 142 million miles away from the sun. Earth is 93 million miles away from the sun. We usually use astronomical units. The distance between Earth and Mars, or I should say the sun and Earth, is called 1 AU, an astronomical unit. Mars is at 1.5, another half the distance between Earth and the sun, away from the sun. In general, the further you are away from the sun means Mars would be a little cooler. Temperature, average minus 81 degrees F. So not just a little bit colder, but a lot colder. The atmosphere on Mars, mostly carbon dioxide. So you can't breathe. The atmosphere itself on Earth is pushing against you. It's 14.7 pounds per square inch. The tires in your car are usually pressurized, about 35 PSI. Just on you in general, holding your body together is 14.7 pounds per square inch. On Mars, it's 0.147, so 1/100th the pressure that it is here on Earth. In other words, on Mars, you would start to expand. Mars orbits the sun about 23 Earth months. And so now Mars's trajectory through space takes it longer to go around the sun than it takes us. When Earth goes around the sun once, what is it called?
Orbit.
A year, and it's called an orbit. We can go just by distance that a Martian year is gonna be a little bit longer than that, 687 Earth days. Does anybody remember the mnemonic to do the order of the planet? My very
educated mother just served us 9.
Yeah, beautiful. Okay, so that's fantastic. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and then now to Pluto, if we consider Pluto a planet or not anymore. With the propulsion that we have now and the way we do it, we can get a machine to the surface of Mars in approximately 6 to 7 months. If we want to send human beings there, it's probably going to be on the order of 2 years. And there's a reason for that. We have to shake what's ever on top of that rocket. We don't want to shake the people till they're not there anymore. So we got to make sure we do that a little bit softer. To get to Mars with a human mission, it's going to take us about 2 years. So it's 2 years there, and then whatever it takes on the surface, if we're going to stay there for a while, and then about 2 years back. It takes, in the best period of time, when Mars is really, really close to Earth, it takes about 4 minutes one way at the speed of light for communication to go from Earth to Mars. The gravity that you feel is more or less based on the diameter or the size of the planet that you're on. And being that Mars is approximately a third of the size of Earth, that means the gravity that you're going to feel on Mars is about a third of what it is here. We're going to talk a little bit about the magnetic field around Earth and Mars. On Earth, we have these things called Van Allen belts. The reason the Van Allen belts are there is that we have a liquid core. And that liquid core of our planet spins around and it makes a magnetic field. All the time the sun's sending out really bad stuff. And we are protected from that really bad stuff by that sort of invisible band that goes from the pole to the pole. On Mars we have a very consolidated, very local magnetic field. Maybe it did have a liquid core at some time and it slowed down. And that's why it doesn't have this protection from radiation. Scientists are searching for materials to protect people, right? And that means scientists, engineers, and people like yourselves to come up with new materials that would protect us on the surface of Mars from things that could hurt us, harmful radiation. Mars was, in its development and past its development, Mars was hit multiple times with different spatial bodies, asteroids, meteorites, etc. And all the things that you see are ejecta from craters. All these rocks have just been thrown out from the surface of Mars. We have really good evidence, very, very strong evidence that there was once water on Mars. In fact, the Mars Exploration Rovers actually have proven that there was liquid water on the surface of Mars. and that we know at the ice caps with the Phoenix lander that there's water ice frozen at the caps of Mars. So there is water there, and that's very important to us. Why? Yes, right here in front. Exactly. Right? The reason that we exist here on Earth is because we have water. If you go about 7 days without drinking water, you will die. There's no question about it. I'm sorry. It's just the way it is. How do we get food? Is it going to be that we call up McDonald's every day and have them ship stuff across the, you know, planetary space? Well, you got to think about that, right? How are you going to eat on a surface of Mars where there's no plants, there's no vegetation, there's no animals? We're learning more and more every day about our planetary neighbor, and that's Mars. Someday we may use this knowledge to build safe and thriving communities there, right? So that's one of the things I think that you guys are tasked with doing, is coming up with a safe community for Mars. Okay, thank you guys very much. I hope you got some information. In a little bit.
A beautiful day without a cloud.